Hello everyone, my name is Mohan Sonale. I am working in the Chapman School of Technology, College of Engineering as an assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Telecommunications. Our subject is Digital Logic Design. I am here to present on introduction of digital electronics. This is the second lecture of our series. In the previous lecture, we studied basic of digital electronics. What are the signals, types of signals, definition of analog digital signal, advantage of analog signal, advantage of digital signal, why analog digital signals are very good as compared to analog signals, what are the different circuits which you use for the construction of digital circuits, what are the digital circuits looks like, and contents of our subject digital logic designs. In this interaction, we are going to study a specific part, number system. So, the contents of my today's interaction is here. Before start our presentation, the first point or first question comes in our mind. What is the need? Why we have to study a number system? What is the importance of number systems? First, according to this, our title, to communicate. To communicate, we know that when each person wants to communicate with each other, then they use a particular language. The particular language is made up of letters or words. And when any person wants to communicate with the digital computers, then computer should be know only numbers, binary numbers, zeros and ones, because there are different input output devices such as keyboard and mouse. There are so many numbers, digits, alphanumerics are available on the keyboards. These keywords having a specific ASCII code, and these ASCII codes having values into form of zeros and ones. So to communicate with the computer, we need number systems. The next, which type of, the another point is that to perform tasks. Which type of tasks we have to perform? First, we know that a computer is nothing but calculation of different arithmetic operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. To perform these arithmetic operations, this computer only knows the values in the terms of zeros and ones. So, to perform arithmetic operations, we have to study a number system. To start our current topic, that is number systems, let's take a review in which way these numbers are represented in the computers or in the digital electronics. Here, first, a single bit produces two different values. How these values are produced? By using this formula 2 raised to n. Here n is nothing but number of bits. If you consider 2 bits, 2 raised to 2 bits, 2 raised to 2 becomes 4. So it produces 4 different values 00, 01, 10 and 11. If the number of bits are 3, 2 raised to 3 becomes 8. So it produces 8 different values, starts from the 000 and 111. If the number of bits are 4, so it produces 2 raised to 4 at 16 different values, starts from the 0000 to 1111. In this way, information is represented into digital electronics. From these values, we can calculate the number of bits also. These are some examples of that. Then next, in the number systems, we have to form small groups. A single bit is nothing but represented with the bit. Nibble is nothing but combination of 4 bits. Byte is nothing but combination of 8 bits. That is a combination of 2 nibbles also. A word is nothing but combination of 16 bits. It is also called as combination of 2 bytes. Double word is nothing but 32 bits, which is combination of 2 words or combination of 4 bytes. In this way, groupisms are carried out into binary exists or binary number systems. So, next part is that classification of number systems. The first type is that decimal number system. In the decimal number system, it consists 10 different digits from 0 to 9. The base of decimal number system is 10. This decimal number system is called as a positional value system because each place having its own value or own weightage. So it is called as a positional value system. And another important point is that each and every number system, the largest value is always worth less than the base. Here are some examples which are concerned the decimal number system, in which each and every example the value of this 7 is going to be varied. In the first example, the value is 700. In the second example, the value of 7 is 70. And in the third example, the value of 7 is 7. In this way, this is a positional value system. Then next type of number system is the binary number system. This binary number system is only 2 digits, 0s and 1s. The base of binary number system is 2. Next, this is also positional value system. The binary number consists represented as 1 1 0 1 0. After this, the base should be right here. Then it is called as a binary number system. Then next, octal number system. The octal number system consists 8 different values, starts from the 0 and ends with the 7. In this number system also, largest value is always less than the base. Here base is the 8. The example of octal number system is 726 with the base of 8 value. Next, hexadecimal number system. In hexadecimal number system consists 16 different values. Apart from that, 0 to 9 are alphabets, numbers, and A to F are alphabets. So, first, numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and alphabets are A, B, C, D, E, and F. These alphabets having equivalent values are A is equal to 10, B is equal to 11, C is equal to 12, D is equal to 13, E is equal to 14, and F is equal to 15. And one more thing, the base of hexadecimal number system is 16. If you consider again, the largest value is always 1 less than the base. So hexadecimal number value, the largest value is 15, and which is less than the base value. Then after study of the different number systems, now we interact with the conversion of number systems. First, base are to decimal. Here are different number systems, that is binary, octal and hexadecimal. If you want to convert into decimal number system, then which steps we have to follow? First example, binary to decimal conversion. Just note down all the bits from LSB to MSB. Multiply each bit or digit with the power of the base from LSB to MSB with the starting power is 0. So, first consider LSB is 0 into 2 raised to 0 plus 1 into 2 raised to 1 plus 0 into 2 raised to 2 plus 1 into 2 raised to 3 plus 1 into 2 raised to 4. After this writing of the power of the different bases, then multiply each digit with the power value. 0 into 2 becomes 0 plus 1 into 2 raised to 1 becomes 2 plus again 0 into any value becomes 0 plus 1 into 2 raised to 3 becomes 8 plus 2 raised to 4 becomes 16, 16 into 1 becomes 16. So total addition of this is 26, which is the equivalent decimal number. Again, consider another number system, that is octal to decimal. This is the octal number system, 726. which is represented into decimal number system. First, write down from LSB to MSB 6, 2 and 7. Multiply each digit with the power of the base, which starts from the 8 power 0 into 6 plus 8 power 1 into 2 plus 8 power of the 2 into 7. And after multiplication of each value, just add all these numbers and total equivalent number is 470, which is the equivalent decimal number system. Again, consider a hexadecimal number system. Again, we have to convert in the similar way. Just we have to take a precaution. This, and instead of this alphanumeric value, we have to consider equivalent numbers. B is nothing but 10 and F is nothing but 15. Only these precautions we have to consider for the hexadecimal to decimal convergence. Next, if you want to convert decimal number system to other number systems, then there are different parts into decimal number systems due to this decimal point. This decimal number is divided into two different parts, integer part and fractional part. So, to find out any other number system for the integer part and fractional part is a little bit different. First, carried out the integer part. Take the integer part of the decimal number and divide the integer part of decimal number by the base of required number system. Here the base of required number system will be 2, 8 or 16. Next, the digit that is remainder of the first step after performing division by the first step, the first remainder is nothing but LSB, that is least significant bit or least significant digit. The next step is keep on dividing and noting the remainders until the quotient is 0. Once the quotient is 0, then we have to stop the division process. And the last remainder is nothing but MSB, that is the most significant bit or MSD, most significant digit. In this way, we have to just write down all the remainders into reverse directions. This is the 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. This is the equivalent binary number of this integer part. Okay. Then next, what about the fractional part? Rules for the fractional part. Take the fractional part of decimal number and multiply fractional part by the base of required number system. Again, base will be going to vary due to binary, octal or hexadecimal. Which number system you want to convert? Then, the result after multiplication, the result of this produces a carry signal. Here, the red symbol or number is nothing but carry. The multiplication of first step produces a carry is called as MSB, that is the most significant bit or MSB. Keep multiplying and noting the carry until you have to follow 4 or 5 steps. After that, write down all the carries into downward directions. This is equivalent to binary or octal or hexadecimal numbers. Take one example, that is decimal to binary. Convert this decimal number into binary number systems. Here, decimal number consists again two parts, integer part and fractional part. So, consider first integer part. Divide the integer part by the base of required number system. The base is required number system binary. So, divide 22 by the 2. First one is 11 and remainder is 0. Again, divide 11 by 2, 5. Here remainder is 1, again divide by 5 by 2, 4, again here remainder is 1, divide by 4 by 2, remainder is 0, and again here remainder is 1. So, note down all this into reverse direction, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. This is the equivalent integer part. Okay. Then what about the fractional part? Consider only fractional part 0.36 into multiply it with the base of required number system. Where base of required number system is required number system is binary, so base is 2. 0.36 into 2 becomes 0.72. So value is 0. It is called as MSD, that is most significant digit. Consider only fractional part of the previous state 0.72 into 2 produces 1.44. Here 1 is the carry. Next, only consider 0.44 fractional part and multiply it with the 2. It produces 0.88. 0 is again carry part. Consider 0.88 and again multiply it with the 2. Produces 1.76. In this step, 1 is the carry. Consider only fractional part 0.76 into 2. So it produces result 1.52. In this way, 1 is the LSD, that is least significant digit or least significant bit. This will be reproduced equivalent binary number. Just note out into downward direction, that is 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. Let's take another example of decimal to octal number system. Here the dividend will be different because the required number system is octal, hence the dividend it will be 8. So integer part is 45, so divide 44 by 8, it will produce 54. This is the required octal number. Consider only fractional part, that is 0.24. We have to multiply this fractional part with the base of required number system. Here base of required number system is 8. So first 0.24 into 8 becomes 1.92. 1 is the MSD. Only consider 0.92 fractional part into 8 produces 7.36. So 7 is the carry. Next, consider 0.36 fractional part into 8, 2.88. 2 is the carry of this state. Only fractional part is 0.88 into 8, it will be 7.04. 7 is the carry of last state, is called as the least significant digit. So note down all the carries into downward direction, hence the value is 1727. Hence the required number octal number system of 44.24 is nothing but 54.1727. Let's proceed with the decimal to hexadecimal number system. Then we have to follow same process for the integer part as well as fractional part. Only changes here the multiplier and dividend will be different because we need a hexadecimal number system. So it will be 16, we have to divide and we have to multiply by the 16. Only change is that if the 14 value is produced, we have to convert into equivalent alphanumeric digits. 14 is equivalent to E and 11 is equivalent to the B. So write down all carriage into downward direction. So equivalent number is 56.1ED85. This is the required hexadecimal number. This is the up to this we will study conversion of one number system to decimal number system, conversion of decimal number system to the different number systems. Now we will study conversion of binary number system to the other number systems. First, we want to convert a binary number into equivalent octal number system. You know what are the rules? To convert a binary number to octal numbers, these steps should be followed. We have to, starting from the LSB, that is least significant bit, mix a group of 3 bits. Here, the important part is that why we have to make a group of 3 bits. If you go through octal number systems, the octal number systems consists from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It consists 8 different values. To represent 8 different values, we need group of three bits. We need a group of three bits. So in the octal number systems, we have to make a group of three bits, which starts from the LSB to MSB. If there are one or two bits are left in making the groups, zeros can be added after the most significant bit. Suppose due to some problem only consists one bit or two bits, then we can add extra zeros into MSB position and convert each group into equivalent octal number systems. Just one example. In this example, we have to convert 1101 01 001 octal number systems. Okay, just we collect the bits in two groups of three, which starts from the LSB, which is 100 is the first group, 101 is the second group, and third group is the 011. This is the three groups: first group, second group, and third group. 001 is nothing but 101 is nothing but equivalent to 5, and 110 is equivalent to the 6. So 651 is the equivalent octal number systems. Binary to hexadecimal number system. Only change is that we have to make a group of 4 bits, because to represent hexadecimal numbers, we need a group of 4 bits which starts from the LSB to MSB. Otherwise, the process will be same. Just look in these examples. We have to make a group of 4 bits from LSB to LSB. 1001 0101 1011. This produces 3 different groups of 4 bits. It is equivalent to the 8421 8 plus 1 9 8 4 2 1 8 plus 2 10, and 1101 will be 13. This number will be equivalent to the alphanumeric. 13 is equivalent to the D, 10 is equivalent to the A, and 9 is equivalent to the 9. No change in these numbers. So this is equivalent hexadecimal numbers. We already discussed binary to decimal number system at the starting of this interaction. Then next, octal to binary number system. Just to convert octal number into binary, each octal digit is converted into 3 bit binary equivalent. These two will be represented as 010. This 6 is nothing but 110, and these 2 is nothing but 010, because we use 8421 combinations. Due to this, this type of binary will be comes in pictures. This is another example where we are going to be convert this octal number system into equivalent binary number systems. Next, octal to hexadecimal, hexadecimal to binary number system. In this hexadecimal number system, we have to make a group of 4 digits. And these 4 digits is nothing but equivalent binary numbers. Thank you very much. If you have any doubt in this slide, you can pass a comment regarding this. I hope so this interaction will be good to all of you. Thank you very much.